Cheerio Beauty just got some new fabrics in.
They have.
In fact, I've already put in my order. They really are incredible. Down the grapevine, the Chio Rio Boutique just got some new fabrics in. Please make a reservation in advance.
They have.
In fact, I've already put in my order.
Welcome back, Mangler3. I'm here. We're going to continue with Genshin Impact. And it sounds like it's already started. I'll go ahead and flip over to that if I can find the button for it. There we go. All right, we'll continue some of the quests and then see if we can wrap up this temporary event, Mega Mecha Melee. Looks like there's pretty much nothing else. Let's look in the shop. Yeah, there's basically nothing else. So let's definitely finish this story and then we'll try the other event. Feedback on the board doesn't look right. Shouldn't we be receiving naught but high praise? It wasn't like this before. Quite unexpected, yes, I suspect foul play. Fortunately, our boss has in his wisdom prepared a contingency plan. Well, of course he has. Why else do you think he's the boss? Arben, Albert is Livre here. In? He's got something for us, apparently. Ah, right on time. Here comes the contingency now. What contingency? Well, that's you. That's what the boss said, but he's not here right now, so let us explain. Just a short explanation once again. During the last 2 days, we released the results of our champion duelist plan to the public. We also started pre-orders that will allow people to pay half price as a deposit and thus qualify for early access. We also placed an evaluation column, that is to say the message board at the door in the store, upon which people could leave their profuse praises. That's what they call building hype. Just as the boss expected, our store really did get very popular, but very few people placed pre-orders, and the amount of praise left in the other column was lamentably low. You lack sincerity, this, but where's the internal quality control of that? Get with the times, such are the reviews we've gotten. Looks like the market wasn't quite what you expected, huh? I fear things are not so simple. We have a saying around here that where there's smoke, there's fire. That is to say that something never arises from nothing. In other words, someone is spreading rumors. Baseless, scurrilous rumors that smear us. That smear us irresponsibly. That irresponsibility. Irresponsibly invent disparaging fictions and defamatory fabrications. The boss is sure that his brother is the one, only one who can be behind the smear campaign. La Pote or Horlogerie has the most to be worried about if this plan succeeds after all. So what do you want to do? Hire us to smear them right back? Lady Farina above, how could you ever think of such a thing? Our boss is Karen's elder brother, after all. Even if they might stoop to such low and vulgar means, we will defeat them fair and square. Exactly. Only this way can the elder brother reform his wayward little brother. What are we needed for in that case? To get them to reveal what they mean by sincerity and internal quality control, of course. Reveal what now? Is that not fair? And is Fontaine not the nation of fairness? That's not what fairness means. The boss said that since people say everyone seems to think that the other party's packaging has been done with sincerity, we should keep pace with them. We shall package our champion duelist as they package adventure. Adding that to our wealth of data will guarantee us a comeback victory. Packaging. Nah, they just turned an adventurer's tale into a toy, that's all. Oh, that must be it. Please ask them what it is. That story must be the packaging we speak of. I too have heard a little something. It seems that while Karen was drunk, he accidentally let slip that this toy was made due to a certain person. Imagine what the grand tale they must have shared to inspire such words from him. Huh? Really? You know, Mangler, I'm suddenly kind of curious as to what that story might be. Why don't we try going back and ask him? Will you? Oh, splendid, splendid. We shall leave this in your capable hands, then, Ms. Paimon, Mr. Mangler. Shows me coming from that direction. Hello again, dear customers. How have you been? Have you tried out the adventurer toy, by the way? Hey there, Karen. Actually, we've got some things we want to consult you about, and it's about the toy. Ah, happy coincidence. Then I enjoy those. Like a fortuitous opportunity to nap, or just happening to have enough mora to buy what you'd like to. Ask away. Like to hear the story behind this toy. That's right, we've heard that you base this toy on someone. That's gotta be the adventurer who's the star of the tale, right? Haha, I see, so that's your question. Well, that adventurer did indeed leave a deep impression on me. I met an adventurer in Springvale while I was about to leave Mondstadt. It appeared that he had messed up some sort of meal delivery commission. Apparently, he had encountered several waves of monsters on the way there, and not only had he missed the timing, but the food had also been bumped about. Knowing a thing or two about cooking, I helped him make a new serving. Well, that sure was nice of you. Well, that's not all. You might find it hard to imagine, but that one attempt at cooking resulted in all manner of accidents. The firewood got wet, a big hole got gouged in the bottom of the pot, and while I was plating up, I was hit with a few flying stones from out of nowhere. One of them even bounced onto my head. Now that one really hurt, but the job did eventually get done, albeit with a complaint about a customer that they'd cracked a tooth on a stone while eating. Lady Farina above. Surely it wasn't the stone that hit us on the head. Was this adventurer's name Bennett? That was his name. Wait, do you two know him as well? Interesting fellow, that one. Later, he took me to all sorts of rarely visited places in Mondstadt to show his thanks. It was a pretty rough journey, but the uncommonly beautiful sights made it worth the effort. I wouldn't take him for a travel enthusiast had he not told me that he had discovered those places by losing his footing during adventures. Or from getting lost. On the day of my return to Fontaine, he came to say goodbye, and there I asked him if he considered his unlucky disposition bothersome. He just gave me a thumbs up and said, "The world is full of all sorts of people, and maybe I just happen to be the unluckiest." But thanks to that, I've also become the bravest person, and that's given me access to sights only I can see. What a brilliant way of putting things. Walking the path of misfortune with a big smile on one's face. Perhaps that's the spirit of a true adventurer. That's right, Bennett's the most adventurous adventurer for sure. And if bad luck can be infectious, perhaps that adventuring spirit could be too. With any luck, the latter can spread far further than the former. I wonder, will this story give you enough material for your report? How'd you figure that one out this time? Well, where there's smoke, there's fire. That's what we say in Fontaine. If you really wanted to know about this story, you'd have asked the first time. But since you're only doing that now, I can only guess that my brother put you up to it. So you really did know. Yeah, you know, Paimon doesn't get why Laver would have such a dim view of you. You're pretty smart, and you seem like a nice guy. It's anger, I think. He's probably still mad at me for what he sees as a betrayal. Eh? Betrayal? Our family's well known for our skills in making clockwork devices. I've always been good at making toys of that sort, and my brother isn't quite as good. He's got a real knack for doing business. Since we both love toys, we've agreed that when we grew up, we would set up the best toy store ever. But it was only when we grew up that we realized that someone had to succeed the family business, and that is to say, this shop. My brother had a big fight with our father over that, and he went to strike out on his own. And on the other hand, was convinced. I, on the other hand, was convinced to stay, and it was not. It, and is that not a betrayal? Does that really count, though? Well, it was a show of venturousness. That was for sure. I was afraid that if I failed to make a name for myself out there, I'd have to come crawling back to the family business. I just couldn't take that pressure. I've always been like that. I'd be the first to cry when we encountered some hooligans on the streets. But my brother would have me get behind him as a, "Don't worry, watch me send him them flying with my knuckle sandwich." Your relationship seems kind of complicated. Well, I suppose that's how things play out, eh? In any case, I'll be here if you have any more questions. You're always welcome here in my shop. Meow. Oh my gosh. I didn't think it would react. I made the cat jump. I thought it was gonna not do anything. Boss, our two guests have returned. Quick as ever, I see. I suppose you gained much from your investigations? Huh. You know, Lever, you... Why do you always show up later? Well, I suppose I'm remiss. I shall strive to come earlier next time. Anyway, about that toy. You tell him about Bennett. He frowns. Toy based on an adventurer named Bennett. I see. And another thing. We didn't ask him, but Paimon thinks your brother didn't badmouth your shop. He doesn't look like the type. Oh, how so? He seems to be sorry about something concerning you. You pass his words on. He gazes it through you, seems like a look of indeterminate distance, like a camera adjusting its focus. After a while, a dissatisfied noise struggles something. He asked me, I don't think that idiot would do something like that either. Wait, so what was this whole contingency thing about? Boss was just looking for an excuse, I suppose. More likely than not, I say. Well, he is a businessman. Businessmen have reputations to consider. And he's the big brother, is he not? The big brother's got a name to uphold, you know? Say any more, or you'll eat my knuckle sandwich. Haha, Lever's exactly what Karen said he'd be like. Well, dear guests, I was just thinking that I should go pay that idiot a visit. Whoa, are you going to put your differences aside and go ask him for advice then? Of course not. But if he thinks he's betrayed me and feels bad about it, shouldn't I give him the opportunity to apologize to my face? He did say that, but Paimon doesn't think that it's the sort of betrayal that someone needs to apologize for. Well, it's decided. Arvin, there's no need for any further pre-orders. Return all deposits as needed, and keep that evaluation board. What? Boss, but so we're not executing the plan anymore? What about data collection? There's still time to make adjustments. No, the data collection continues. I have other plans for that. And you've got payments to collect, don't you? I always do honest business. Suspiciously honest in this case. The boss is the boss, even when he's being stubborn. Humph. I wouldn't call his attitude toward toys completely worthless. I'll pay a visit to the Pâte à l'Horlogerie once the next 2 days of data collection are complete. I'd like you two to come too, good customers. I've got some other things to settle here in the shop, so if you'll excuse me. Lever's got such an odd temper. He's not really going to ask for an apology, is he? Well, would you look at that, our third party has brought about an opportunity for change once again. Third party? That's the two of you, of course. Thanks to you, the differences between the two shop owners might yet be resolved. And that's what happened previously, too. Previously? Have you noticed how this shop is separated from the Pâte à l'Horlogerie by the Northland Bank? Boss originally wanted to set up shop next to the Pâte à l'Horlogerie to compete with them directly. Now I doubt that they knew about the boss's history when they reserved that space, but in some way they became a mediator in the conflict, didn't they? That's super interesting. The Fatui love to meddle in other people's business, but this sort of meddling's a first for sure. And that's the importance of third parties. Just like how a double act still needs an audience. Well, what about solo acts? Would things work with just one actor and one audience? Wait, are you trying to betray me too? You better watch out for my knuckle sandwich then. Two days later. I think we can handle that. Oh, we have a new frenzy request. We've got space, sure one. I'm gonna try right after 10. I'll be back in 1 second. Okay, I'm back. Let's see. Was that enough time? It was. Alright, let's go see if he's gonna pay him a visit at midnight. Let's see if this guy jumps when I shoot him. Didn't even flinch. Did, look at that. I see you're doing well, Karen. Brother, what are you doing here? We haven't seen each other in so long, and that's what you choose to say? I just didn't expect you to come over to see me. I mean, our shops are quite close together, but you never came over. I just thought you were still angry with me. I'm not here to talk to you about what happened before. I'm just going to ask you this. That adventurer toy was made because of me, right? I knew I wouldn't be able to hide anything from you. Well, wait, now Paimon's confused. Wasn't that toy inspired by Bennett? Ah, I see you two have arrived as well. I'm sorry for not explaining previously, but I didn't know where to begin. Although that adventurer did give me critical inspiration, my brother was the real reason I insisted on having the toy made. I can see why you might be complicated for you. Or, I don't really get what was so difficult about all this. I'll say it first. Karen, your mawkishness hasn't changed one bit. You haven't changed either, brother. I'm more and more convinced that you and the adventurer are the same type of person. I don't have a vision, nor am I an adventurer, but you have the same adventurous spirit. Bennett lives in an adventure, while you live your core adventure. Did you pick that flattery up from me too? How can that be? You've never been a flatterer. You've never hesitated to tell me that I haven't any fighting spirit, and while the truth is frustrating, it is the truth nonetheless. You've always been trying to be the best toy merchant ever, but I acceded to the family's arrangements, continuing the cycle of clockmaking. Only people like you and Bennett could turn their passions into their profession. I cannot. It would take a hundred of me to match your courage. Come on, don't say that about yourself. There's no point in hiding this. When my brother first stated his intentions to move his shop next to mine, my first reaction was to consider moving the shop. Father would be ashamed, and rightly so. But in the end, the Northland Bank took that spot and separated us. A happy coincidence again, you could say. Yeah, Arvin told us about it. Humph. Do you really think the world is so full of happy coincidences? That the Northland Bank just so happened to come between us at the time? What do you mean, Liver? I had reserved that spot long ago, but a new idea struck me, and so I transferred it to them for a low price. This didn't just come out of nowhere, you know. So you were the one who got them involved, huh? Did you think that your previous decision was too impulsive or something? Ever since I left, my goal has always been to be the greatest toy merchant. But what sort of greatness would that be if the family feud between my brother moved away in the process? Huh? Hehehe, that sounds like concern to Paimon. You were just making excuses when you said you wanted Karen to apologize, weren't you? Apologize? What apologize? Did I ever say that? Wow, that's a really earnest denial, considering that you actually did say it. I'm here to congratulate you, Karen. That toy is quite well made. It's been such a long time since I heard a word of praise from you, brother. I didn't think that. I've also brought you a gift. Here's the data I had these two adventurers gather over the last few days. This should help you create something even more interesting. Huh? But weren't you going to make the toy champion duelists? That data is important to you, isn't it? That plan's suspended. The market shifted faster than I thought, so some ad hoc adjustments will be necessary. But this data, how could I just take it? You take it when I give it to you, obviously. In that case, I'll take it for safekeeping. Feel free to reclaim it should you ever need it again. So Liver's other plan was to give the data to his brother. I apologize, dear customers, that I did not ask for your suggestions first before doing this. Oh, it's fine. You paid us, didn't you? And this is your personal matter. This was totally worth it, if your relationship with your brother can be improved. Right, Mangler? Our thoughts are aligned in this. Indeed. Or, we're honest businessmen, too. I'll say the first one. Hehe. Guess this was a successful third-party intervention. Oh, right. Liver, Karen, since we're all here, why don't you strike while the iron's hot and work together on something? We're good at making stuff, Karen. And we can have Liver do the advertising. If you do it as a team, I'm sure it will work out. I appreciate your good intentions, but there's no need. I feel the same way. Wait, so this is what you two are going to agree on? That Bennett fellow said this too, didn't he? The world is full of all sorts of people. You did remember that part. The world is full of all sorts of people, and they all have sights that only they can see. If I learned anything from this at all, this would be it. Karen and I are just two different people, which is why we've set out on different paths. Perhaps he thinks that my path is too adventurous, and I, for my part, can't stand the kind of placid existence he leads. That's right, if the hour hand does the minute hand's work, it will get fired without compensation the next day. And while intense challenges are an adventure, it is a simple life, not one as well. Everyone's on their own journey of adventure. So since we've each chosen our direction, let's walk down that path and seek our own unique sights. And I'll occasionally go meet with you. After all, your road will be quite difficult. Pfft, don't you worry about me. At least I know you'll how to enlist third parties to help me out of jams. I didn't just sit around waiting for these adventurers of the Northland Bank, let me tell you that. And what will you do when there's a problem that even a third party can't solve? I'm sure you know how the stiffer a gear is, the less durable it will be. I worry that if we meet, we'll meet. What else can we do, huh? That's just life. No, you won't be defeated by life, just like Bennett. And if things prove otherwise, yeah, I'll send you flying with a knuckle sandwich. Ha, brat, listen to yourself, talking to your big brother like that. Don't get too cocky. Well, if Lady Farina can sit at the judge's desk for a while, then a little brother can borrow his big brother's minds, right? Haha, I see you're figuring us Fontanians out. I'd like to ask you something. So if you're free, let's meet outside my shop later. That's all I have to say today, Karen. I'll be heading back now.
We're way behind schedule.
You're here. Well, you seem to be in a good mood. Thanks to your help, speaking of which, Karen's trip to Mondstadt gave me an idea. Perhaps I should go travel around for a bit and find some inspirations for toys myself. You've traveled the world, you probably know some friends like that Bennett. Do you have any suggestions for me? Well, we do have a lot of friends, but when it comes to toy inspiration, that might be a bit tough. Why not look for a third party? Eh? We're a valid third party, aren't we? Are you referring to the Northland Bank? Oh, you meant the previous third party. Oh, let Paimon think. The Northland Bank is under the Fatui, and the Fatui are under... Are you referring to a Harbinger? Do you mean that we can make a toy themed after a Harbinger? Huh? Mangler, do you mean... Oh, Paimon gets it. Hey, Liver, did you know that there's a very special Harbinger? Whom they call the greatest toy salesman in Shetsnaya? What? Is there such a person? And they're talking about child. Of course, and he's a real expert too. Maybe he'll inspire you, and you know, a toy merchant and a seller would make a pretty awesome combo. Don't you think? Thanks for your suggestion. They've been very helpful. I don't think it would be easy to get in contact with the Harbinger, but I do have some connections at the Northland Bank. I'll see what I can do. Don't forget to invite us to try whenever you... new toy you come up with. I will. Keep an ear out for news from me. Aha! A story with a possible continuation. And I think we finished that whole section. Let's see if they give us anything for doing that. Oh, I guess they already did probably. And we got a little bit more to buy something. The store is almost empty. We drained it. We've taken pretty much everything. Let's do this test run before we forget. This will give us even more gems. These gems can get us wishes, new characters. Zhongli's now up. We can try for him too after this. He's like one of the strongest, if not the strongest character in the whole game. This is him. Watch how fast he wastes these guys. Notice he has not been hit yet. This is what this thing is. Boom. Basically undefeated. As hard as well. Oh, we get Kitching. She's a 5-star and she gets to be a backup there. That's pretty awesome. Goodbye. I don't think he got hit once the entire round. Like a momentary lapse there. I don't know what that was. Alright, let's do our wishes. Actually, I think we have to claim that reward. Claim. We could also get him 20. Let's go ahead and, well, we'll see if we get enough to get a wish and then we'll come back on him. Alright, so we need 3 more. We got plenty to get 3 more. Alright, here we go. And it's purple. Purple means 4-star. I think it was a new character as one of the possibilities, though. And of course, we get a weapon. I already have like 10 points. Lane. We need 8 more. We can afford 5 more. We have to do some more quests. And one of those quests to do is this test run. Well, let's get this child run out of the way, grab these free 20. 20 in about a minute. Sort of like daily. Swing the sword a few times and that'll go with it. He's a little bit overbuffed here. Put out this flame real quick. See, he can beat him a little bit faster than the other guy, Zhong Li, but notice he's got hit a couple. Down. A lot to go. I think 408, 460 to go. Aha, here's the new character, Fremenae. We've done Sayu before. Let's do Fremenae. Let's try one time just to see. I bet they act like a dolphin too. Like Dallas said, everybody from Fontaine, when they get to the top of the water, they're like a dolphin and they skip. Oh, he's ice. I thought he was another person. Works good with water. Okay, some water always go well. Whoa, he put on a scuba hat. Oh, he's got a scuba hat on. I wonder if I need him if I keep doing the scuba thing. That was cool. Okay. Verdict of Blades. Let's go knock this one. It's like the best rewards are for the perilous one. Actually, you probably get extra if you do the higher ones. Let's try the highest one for the first one and see if it's possible. If it's not, we'll just go back to the easy one. You never know till you try. With all the different changes these days, you never know. Also, I'll switch to my controller so I can swing a little faster. Probably plug it in for that. Bring it on. I but steadfast. So it's just a level of difficulty. You just have to beat everybody in 180 seconds.
Another test subject.
New enemy, huh? That was actually a misclick. I meant to do this. What's that little spinning thing there? Good or bad? I want to avoid it. Or go near it. Or near it. That should be no problem. Two, got three, got four, Okay, so I might not be able to do it. I'm so slow. Never know until you try, right? Challenge again. Is it the same or...? How do you equip this? Okay. We'll do Perilous. Thought that would be easy, but these are only 80. What is XP? Thank you. Alright, so it's 6,000 when I have 8,000 ahead of those blocks. So I wonder if I was supposed to pick up the block to make my damage go up. That's okay, I'm not gonna worry about it. Perilous. Only 7 this time. I bet these will be even faster. Phew, that was close. Took a little longer than I expected. Collect our first 2 rewards. Nice. I don't even have ice and these guys are going down pretty quickly. Well, this guy's taking forever. This guy was the one that overheated the computer last time when it crashed last Genshin stream, if you remember last week. My computer was like, oh my god, so much heat. Figured out a trick, if you change it to 99%, it doesn't go to full blast over the moon. I was pretty quick. I might have died, but two more. The reward for the harder difficulty one. I should look and see. You may not tell me if it's okay. One left. That was fast. 37 seconds. Well, since that one was so fast, I'm curious if we were to beat it. How do we do it? If we could beat it on desperate. Okay. Well, let's try. Oops. Try the highest one. On desperate. See if we can do it. And I died. So that it's possible to undo the damage quickly. Wow. Pulled it off. So now we get to go to the up, higher up, I think. Four star. Level 95. I don't think it's possible. There's so many of them. I didn't even stand a chance on that one. Well, let's see. If we go to the map, we can. There's a quest right there. There's also the regular world quest, or the regular main quest. I think we'll try out this little one first, since we happen to be standing right next to it. I'm only going to say this one more time and give it back. Hey sis, she isn't talking. Whatever. Not that there's anything more to talk about anyway. Let's just take this stuff and go. She's all covered with paint. Come on, little one. No need to make that face. Why did we take this job again? Whatever. Hey, Kekabad. What are you just doing just watching over there? Just toss her the boss's mora, and let's take the paintings and go. Eh? Do we have to, though? He doesn't know that we're doing this far out. What we're doing this far out? Why don't we just take the mora and... How do they put it again? Favors are more important than details and mora? To deals and mora? Hey, what are you guys doing? What? What did your pop... Where did you pop out from? Looks like you're bothering this young lady. Her? Bothered? We're just here to buy some artwork. You know? Buying? How much were you going to pay for one? 500,000 mora? 550,000? 600,000? Wait, you don't even have any hard figures at all. Well, that's not our fault. This Melusine won't talk. Well, If she doesn't want to talk to you, then she doesn't have to sell. Then what doesn't want to sell? You're just here to take her stuff, aren't you? Take? This is a fair exchange, a fair and square exchange. We're not going to shortchange her. But what's this to you, anyway? Nonsense. Paimon heard that guy over there talking about taking the Mora. Told you to watch your mouth, you. Does it really matter? Haven't we always solved things this way up until now? Don't you ever shut up. We don't have the time to involve unrelated people. Besides, what are you looking at? Nothing. Buzz off. You're butting into legitimate business here. If not, I'm afraid we might have to resort to less savory methods to settle this. Battle? I don't mind. That's enough. This is Fontaine. Exactly. You know what happens to those who break the law here in Fontaine, don't you? Don't take that tone with me. What happens to those who break the law? My foot. Who do you think you are? Anyway, I'll say this one more time. Stay out of this. This is between us and the kid. Battle? Looks like there's no reasoning with you, or, it seems I must now reveal my true identity. Identity? What's that? I'm an enforcer of the law. Oh yeah, that's right. You've got a good eye, huh? Well, wait, sis. What do we do? What are you worried about? If he's a law enforcer, I'm the Tsarista of Chetsnaya. The Tsar. You're just gonna believe everything people say, are you? And just look at them. Do they look like folks from the Maison Gardenage? That's right, that's the one. Seriously, what's with the ridiculous name? They're just law enforcement. So they might as well call themselves that. Anyway, you think we've never seen people from the Maison before? You aren't even in uniform. Daring imposters, aren't you? I'll have you know that this is the uniform of the Maison Lumitole. Or, we're plain clothes officers, or we're enforcers of the Corps of 30. Eek! It's the Corps of 30. Why are they here? Hey, calm yourself. Why would they be here, huh? We're the Fontaine branch of the Corps. Seriously? Do you think the Corps of 30 are... Who do you think they are anyway? Mints that grow in both Sumeru and Fontaine? They could always be sweet flowers instead, or specters, or the Adventurers Guild, or Catherine. Enough nonsense. If you're intent on stopping us, then we'll just have to show you what for. You two, with me. What did I say? I knew things would come to this in the end. Chase away the Eremites. I did not sign up for this trampoline. They ran off, huh? Why do these people always need to take a beating before they'll cool off, huh? But never mind that. Are you okay? I'm fine, thank you. I'm not very good at dealing with such people. You're very impressive. Well, we are well-honed professional adventurers, after all. People like that can't hold a candle to us, that's for sure. No, I don't mean his skills, anyway. He was the only one fighting. You were just watching. Well, Paimon's a guy. We're just splitting the work, you know, right, Mangler? Anyway, we've said a lot so far. But what should we call you again? Mamere, or Mamir. My name's Mamere. I was painting here, but... Oh, so... Melusines can paint too? Yes, I do. In fact, every day, in fact. Because painting the things that I want to... brings me happiness. Well, aren't you a painter then? I see. I'm not interested in... I'm not sure I understand what you mean, but I guess so. Anyway, let's help gather up the painting tools first. Mangler, consider how short her hands are. Paimon's can't even imagine how she'd hold a brush. But your hands are shorter than mine. Thank you. It would be a long time for me to clean them up. You help her pick up the scattered painting tools. Well, looks like we're more or less done. Good job, Paimon. It was mostly me doing the work, or... Good job, me, more like. You did barely anything, Paimon. Hey, it's called division of labor. Speaking of which, what were those people actually trying to do? Them? They wanted to exchange Mora for the paintings on my hands. Oh, so they wanted to... Wait. Then they were here to buy your art after all? Weren't they? Uh-oh. What did we do? Sounds like... We had good intentions, but we ended up interrupting a business transaction you were having. Business? I don't think you would call it that. Don't both sides have to exchange things to the other needs for it to be called business? I don't need Mora, so that wasn't business. You don't need Mora? Wait, you're not some sort of renowned painter, are you? Renowned? Doesn't that mean people know about you? I guess I could... I count then? Previously, a stranger claiming to be an art collector or something asked to exchange a large sum of Mora for my artwork. A self-proclaimed collector came to you? And they cited a high price to boot. No wonder you said you didn't need Mora. If Paimon could sell her paintings for that much. You can draw too, Paimon? Well, not really. But maybe with some hard work, starting today. Reckon it's not too late for you, or... Not with that attitude, you won't. Paimon knows. But, that makes her so envious. That said, who's that collector you were talking about anyway? A rather cool person, and quite gentle, too. If he hadn't suddenly mentioned Mora, I would have just given off him the painting as a gift. Why do these tall people always love talking about that stuff? Yes, but you can't put a price on art, or I don't think this is a matter of height. Of course, after all, Mora is, well, actually, Paimon doesn't think you can elevate art solely based on Mora, either. Mamere, could Paimon have a look at your paintings? Paimon's curious. About the value of the art, I presume? Hey, Paimon's not always thinking about that stuff. This is appreciation. Appreciation of art, nothing else, alright? Sure, but if you're so interested, Paimon, why don't I draw a portrait of the two of you? Hey, would you really? You helped me chase those troublesome people away, and you helped me gather up my painting tools. I've actually quite been wondering how to thank you all this time. It's just, would a painting of be too odd of a thank you gift to give? No, of course not. Right, Mamere, could we give you some directions regarding the painting, by the way? Sure. But before that, I need to repack my painting tools. Those people knocked my paint buckets over, so there's no way I can work here. We'll need to make a trip home first. Mangler, Paimon, could you wait for me in the village? I'll clean up over here and head down soon. The village. Right, it's our home. We call it Marasi Village. You just need to swim down over here and keep going forward. Okay then, let's go. A brush of seafoam and crimson. They want me to go underwater here. I'm not positive. We'll find out soon. Yeah, we made it. Oh, this is the bonus one. I'm gonna follow this guy. It's probably the one. A very warm place. Waypoint. Yay, three crystals. So I lucky did. Alright, now they want me to go this way. Condescent crystal. What is it? It's unique, so I'm gonna grab it. Figure out what they're for. There's lots of them. I think we made it. Alright there, mezzanine for ya. Their village should be just up ahead. Ah, you're from the outside. Well, welcome. But I don't have flowers to give you right now. Flowers? Aw, come on, there's no need to be so formal. Oh, okay. Well, in that case, let me just welcome you to a very enthusiastically to Marusi village. Welcome. Thanks a lot. Yep, I'm very enthusiastic. So whatever you want to know, I'll tell you all about it. Nice. In that case, could you tell us a bit about Marusi Village? Sure I can. This village is home to lots of Millicenes. Well, you can't see them here, but you will if you keep going forward. Everyone here is a wonderful Millicene. So if you're a good person, you'll definitely be welcomed here. I am a good person. I wouldn't say I've never done any evil. Hey? Oh no. I have to tell my friends who work at the Marechaussee Phantom. Hey, Mangler was just joking. We haven't done anything worth us being pursued by the Marechaussee Phantom. Really? Really? Yes, of course, really. Okay, I trust you. What should I say next? I forgot. But I remember that the ending has, I hope you enjoy your stay in our village. Nice. Shall we go have a look then, Mangler? We'll see you later, Kosan Zina. See you. I hope that next time we meet, I'll have lots of flowers ready for you. Hey, wait a minute. That's a save point. Another one. Mangler, Paimon. Huh? Mamiri, are you surprised, Paimon? And happy that we have met again after all this while? Well, it hasn't exactly been a long while since we last met. Actually, how'd you get back here sooner than us? We didn't see you at all, either. Did you teleport? I came back immediately after packing, and I wound up waiting for you here. Well, alright then. Also, is this Marisi Village, where the houses are kind of small, pretty interesting? Maybe we've got a Melusine chef, a Melusine adventurer, or a Melusine architect who specializes in building Melusine houses in this village. Hey, Mamiri, what does your house look like? My house is pretty and quiet. It's a good place to paint. Come on, it's this one. So, how'd you get to the village before us? There are actually a lot of shortcuts. Father taught us how to find them. You mean your dad? Does he live in the village too? Not in the village? How should I put it? He's all around us. Huh? Foamy home. Hey, another quest. Tempted to start the quest, but I'm gonna actually mark it and then we'll come back to it. If I have room on mark. No pins left. Seriously? Can we get rid of the pin that we just used? Where is the pin that we just used? I feel like it might be that one. Oh well, I'll just come back to it soon. Maybe it'll be the next one. Or maybe I'll start it. Yeah, I'll start it, and that way it's on my list. Veronate. A Tadaga slurry. The crushed innards of Limitoile and a little... Wait, how much is a little exactly? Hey, you making some soup? Erg, that smells really weird. It smells weird. That can't be. I followed the formula Karaboss gave me exactly, so it should smell normal. It smells like someone fermented a sea bass from 3 years ago in a vat of dead frogs. Or, if you calm down a bit, you can smell the fragrance of sweet flowers. Definitely the first one. Erp, did you have to say that? Now Paimon has that image in her head. Anyway, what are you doing? Do you, need help? It's a potion. I'm formulating a potion. One that'll help lots of people. Oh, you're a potioneer, eh? Then, not yet. I'm an assistant to a master potioneer. Her name is Karaboss, eh? And I, Verinata, still have much to learn from her. Well, an assistant to a great doctor must be a great assistant, right? Yeah, well, wait, no, not at all. There are so many things I still don't know. I'm just working as hard as I can to help make her potion. Also, I've told you my name, but I don't know yours yet. Paimon's Paimon, and this is Mangler. Paimon, what a nice name. Reminds me of a noisy white jellyfish. Mangler, that's a slightly strange name. It gleams like gold, but it's very friendly. Pleased to meet you. And, well, you just asked if I need help, and I do. But I don't know if I'd be willing to... If you'd be willing to help. Ask away. Exactly. If you need help, you should just say so. I'd like you to try my new potions. Hey, I know potions smell and taste bad, but they can help lots of people and cure many illnesses. They're very useful things. But we can't get sick, and we don't like drinking strange things. Over time, people stopped helping me taste my potions, and that's been a big problem for me. You're the one who said this stuff is weird. It's Is it dangerous? It is dangerous. It isn't dangerous, is it? It's fine. We don't get poisoned by them, so you shouldn't either. Well, at least in theory, anyway. There are a total of 3 potions that need testing. One will help people fight better, the other will help people feeling warm, and the last one, I don't know how to put this, but Karaboss says that it can help people understand the truth. That's what she said, anyway. I'm still not sure what it means. That does sound dangerous. No, it's not dangerous. Anyway, would you like to help? If you would, I'll take you to the test site now. I'll help you. Let's go. Just don't go drinking yourself into danger. A while later, you arrive at the beach. Thank you. Let's try the first type then. Don't drink too much of it, Mangler. Just spit it out if something feels off, okay? Don't worry, Paimon, I'll be fine. Paimon's just worried, you know. I'm ready. Pass me the potion. This one's called Super Duper Potion. It'll make you super strong. Well, in theory, at least. You drink it all in one go. Pungent odor, sweet and sticky, hard to swallow. Your body has no reaction to it. And at her direction, you wait until some breacher primuses become active. Defeat all the opponents. These monsters are attracted to the Super Duper Potion. So far, it doesn't seem to be very strong. You really are amazing. Come on, Mangler. Ah, careful. Are they multiplying or are they just saying that kind of almost done? I can jump super high. It's a dancing villager over there. Is this the potion's effect? She disappeared? I thought she was standing right there. I see that there is something here. Something in this boat. Ah, discovered it. Let's see if we can get back there. Don't know where that quest went off to, if we finished the quest or not. but we'll continue this quest. Do we have to go under to get there? No. Nope. Well, this place is my house, and welcome to my humble abode. Please don't mind the mess, and all comments are welcome, and no need to be so formal. So, this place is a quiet spot suited for painting because it's a good distance from the village, eh? I'm back, Seymour. Garbled mechanical noises. Welcome back, m'lady. You are as gentle, lovely, and radiant as ever. Whoa, did the robot dog just talk? Yes, Paimon Mangler, this is Seymour, he's family. Seymour, these two are Mangler and Paimon. They're nice people who stop others from giving me more. Don't phrase it like that. You make it sound like we did something bad. Actually, never mind that. Why can Seymour speak? What do you mean? Of course he can. There'd be something wrong with him if that wasn't the case. Yeah, what Paimon said. No, stop simply agreeing with people, Mangler. No robot dog can talk, no matter where they're from. Since you're from abroad, I guess you know what you're talking about. That said, Seymour can talk and he's also my best friend. He even critiques my paintings. I see. Your judgment is very sharp, m'lady. Just talk again. Mangler, or Paimon, sure that Mamiri isn't doing ventriloquism or anything, but does this their exchange really make sense? It feels mismatched. Did someone give it to you as a gift, or did you fish this out of the water? I'll say first. That's not it. We met when I was looking for paints nearby once. That's when I discovered poor Seymour lying in a pile of junk all alone. So I talked to him and we became friends. Later I brought him back with me so he'd have a home. Still, does this thing have any other functions other than talking? Seymour? Paw. Huh. He seems to only respond to you, Mamiri. He's rude, huh? This Seymour? Well, he's probably just shy. No need to take it personally. Sorry about that. For some reason, Seymour only talks to me. He falls silent when faced with other people, just like this. True. You know, he might be one of those clockwork mecha. Do you just talk to him all the time, Mamiri? Yes, no one in the village really understands art, so there's never much to talk about. I mean, they care about me, but holding our conversation can be tough. They definitely don't show as much interest in my paintings as you do, Paimon. Other than Mr. Jacob, only Seymour ever talks to me about art. Well, Paimon does want to see how cool and pretty she'd look in your work. Also, if this Mr. Jacob a friend of yours, too? Yep, he's the art collector from before who wanted to exchange my paintings for Mora. He was cool and gentle, and he told me all kinds of things about art. He even said that he could understand those paintings. And despite all that, she didn't sell a single one to him in the end, huh? The harder something is to come by, the more incredible it tends to be. Wait, might Mamiri's paintings be priceless treasures? Let's put that aside for now, though. It's time to paint. Ooh, this is the moment Paimon's been waiting for. Is a priceless masterpiece about to be created? I don't think I can do that exactly, but I will do my best to make a worthy gift for you two all the same. I'll prepare my tools. Please wait for me, alright? Okay, let's look around nearby, shall we? Walk around. Box. Huh? This box contains... It's so rude to go through other people's stuff, Paimon. Hey, Paimon just happened to see it, alright? But still, it seems like there's some machine components inside. Though they're a bit... Might these tools be used to maintain Seymour? Guess it might be best not to mess with them, right? You know, Paimon thinks we've seen this type of easel before. Seems from to be a design from outside the village. Speaking of that, how do the Amalasines and Marusa village trade with merchants from outside? My mind doesn't think normal merchants would be any good at diving. Actually, this could be a great business opportunity for us, don't you think? If we took over all foreign trade from Marusi village, we'd be rich. Aye, we'd be rich. I suspect that wouldn't work. Huh? Why wouldn't it work? Yes, they have a specific place they want to move around. Water looks kind of weird. Reflections. Shadows. What's the alien down here? Let's go up. Up, up, and away. It's Seymour. Let's talk to Seymour. Good doggy. You know, Paimon's got a question. Why is Seymour the only clockwork mechanism that can talk? It might be some experimental prototype. Or... that's true. What's the deal with you, Seymour? No response. Guess it's just as Mamiri said. It only speaks to her. I'll check her house. The sound of rummaging comes from behind the door. That was louder than Paimon thought it would be. My pants. They should be here. Bottle. Eh? What's the small bottle for? Only one way to find out. Oh, this looks like paint. There's only a little left, but still. Mangler, are you okay? I'm just a little dizzy. Huh? A flying white fish. Huh? A white fish? Are you sure you're okay? Why don't we sit down and take a break here first? You might be tired from all that swimming. I'm fine now. That's good. Don't push yourself, alright? If you feel sick later, just say so. Mangler? Paimon? Mamiri, are your painting tools ready? Again, welcome to my humble abode. Please don't mind the mess and all comments are welcome. But, I think I'm out of paints. Huh? I mean, the stuff that should have been in that bottle, a warm and beautiful color. Anyway. Sorry. Please wait here a moment. I'll go to gather some paints. I'll be right back. No need to apologize. A priceless masterpiece like the one you'll make should also need priceless paints, after all. Do you need to collect the paints yourself? I do recall us helping Albedo gather Star Silver back then. That's true, but the ore that we picked up didn't really get put to any use, did they? Yes, I want to draw the most beautiful things. Common paints are fine, but they won't be able to portray the warmth that Mangler emanates in Paimon's shininess. Give me a second. I'm going to gather the paints I need. We can help. Yeah, that's right. Your hands are sort of short. You might be kind of tough for you to hold the paint bucket by yourself. My hands aren't short. Also, there's no need to worry. I've always found out to get paints on my own, so I'm used to it. Wait, so you don't have friends accompanying you most of the time? Ahem. Oh, what Paimon means is, sorry. Huh? Why are you apologizing? Oh, I get it, Paimon. You feel bad for me because Seymour can't move and I might be lonely while gathering paint. Right? You're so nice. Thank you. But anyway, we should go together. It'll be more convenient that way, right? Yep, let's go together. If you're both willing, then let's go. Thank you. That makes me so happy. Well, Paimon really does want to see your work, you know. Go to the place to collect the paint. By the way, Mimir, how long would it usually take you to gather paints? Normally about a day, I'd say. A whole day? Usually I try to fill all my paint bottles and that's why I need all day. This time I'm just drawing a little. Okay, well, we're going to the lonely place. Ooh, look what we found. A challenge. Blow up 4 exploding bombs. Got 1. Got 2. Gosh, this is so much easier. Faster. Okay. Hey, we did it. And we're on our way to collect paint.
Beautiful treasures are a cause for great happiness.
Those look like enemies over there. We're going the right way, but we probably have to fight this. We're in the water, so I could probably freeze them. Yep. See those gentle, friendly creatures over there? If you ever get lost, then just follow them. I don't think she's talking about these after I beat this one, a big one's gonna show up. If I can beat this one. And we can like move or fall off the same thing. There we go. What do you mean gentle and friendly? They charged right at us. Oh, sorry guys. My first time encountering such a thing too. Why would they? Don't worry about us, this happens to adventurers often, right? Look, Mangler Paimon, those are the ores that we need. Now what we need to do is... Next is... say no more, we're expert miners. We should know how our pros do it. Please wait. Directly digging isn't going to work. The ores are really hard. We need a prism over there to resonate with them. Let's see, calm down. That will... So that's how we're doing this, huh? As long as we grind this ore into powder, we can make paints, right, Mimiri? Where'd she go? She was here a minute ago. Probably went up ahead. Seriously? Someone that small shouldn't be running around like that. Never mind. Let's head up again. Ahead, too. Oh, are you okay? You're zoning out again. Nothing, just a bit dizzy. Just like before. Have you not had enough to eat or something? Yeah, thanks, Paimon. Thanks, but I don't think I have this as a question of how much I have or haven't eaten. Don't push yourself too hard, alright? Let's keep going, shall we? redstone. Let me hit him with this. Just checking. See, it doesn't do anything. There's another one over there, so it's going to be. Purple's good. Alien life form.
I suppose this will do.
Alright, so I think that's just to hit these ones and do that. Wow, a huge boat and half a house. And these waves. Something casual right there. Eh? Yeah, there's no reaction. Upon closer inspection, this one's not glowing. Try the glowing one. Now it's glowing. There we go. Should be enough. Where did she go? Hi, Mon. Over here. Hey, goodbye, Mon. Whoa. Something, something. Looks like we've already gathered loads of stuff. This should do it, right? Whoa, so much ore. I can make tons and tons of paints with these. Thank you so much. No need. They're all red ore. Will you have enough colors to use? Don't worry about that. Now, time for one last step. Oh, Paimon knows. You're gonna grind the ores and make them into paints, is that right? Well, if you put it like that, continuing the need to grind the paints, there should be two more steps instead. These ores contain a lot of impurities. If we're to make them into paint like this, the colors won't be even. They'll look dirty. Huh. Paimon didn't know there were so many considerations at play. Can guess that's what makes you a master of the arts. What do we do, Master Mamiri? At this time, we need to find purer ones, grind them down, mix the powders together. This way the amount of impurities will decrease and the paints we get from them will be more beautiful. But shouldn't we have just used the purer ones to make the paints from the beginning? There aren't that many high purity ones around, silly. You might as well be saying that if there's no Tidalga to eat, let's have Poisson Cham Pie instead. Whoa, is that a that metaphor sure gives you a distinct taste of Melusine food culture. That said, there aren't any other mineral veins nearby, are there? Yes, we'd need to go further inside this place to find the purer ones we need. Do you want to take a break? I can take care of the rest. It won't be long anyway. We'll go with you. Wait, look over there. Isn't that a red whirlpool wormhole? What is that? It's a shortcut. Have you seen one before? There should have been many of them along the way. Shortcut? Looks pretty ominous for one. This would be what they call a shortcut that's the long way around. Well, I take paths like these. They're safe and warm. Well, if you say so, then we've come this far, we might as well go all the way in helping you find high purity ores. See if I missed anything. Yeah, probably, but I'll go back on trip. Go to a very warm place. First I was at the lonely place, and now I'm at a very warm place. Whoa, Paimon feels nauseous. This shortcut really was something. Was this part of Melusine culture too? On closer inspection, it seems that we did pass this place when we came down. To think that there was such a large stone over there. That's right, this place feels warm and safe, doesn't it? Father told me about it, and it contains high purity ores. I'll take care of the little ones here, so just wait for me. These don't look all that different from the ordinary sort. Uh-huh. But their colors are totally different. Really? They are. Aren't they all red anyway? Well, yes, but there are pretty obvious differences between different shades of red, right? Huh? I couldn't tell. Huh? It's got such a rich texture, and that's certainly different. You're very sensitive. You're really sensitive to colors. Would you like to paint someday? We can paint together. We'll paint your paintings. We'll put your paintings and mine together around the house. You couldn't tell the difference at all, could you? Still, you probably know a lot more about painting than we do, Marie, and about ores and paints too. Either way, Paimon didn't know that painting was such tough work. Mining, gathering, different ores to make paints. Paimon used to think that it was just about putting paint on canvas. Oh. Hey, you feeling alright, Mangler? I hear something. What was that sound? Hey, Mangler. Won't you worry about me? And that's exactly how you get Paimon worried. Could this have something to do with the red ores? Some ores contain toxins that can affect people's minds. But Mimir's been working with these ores all this time, and they should be fine. By the way, what are they exactly? My mom wonders if they fetch a good price. Maybe if we collect some extra and sell it to merchants outside, we might be able to... ores that are even higher in purity. Ooh, Paimon gets it. You mean to say that the high purity ones needed for Mimir's paintings are paints that are the truly invaluable treasures instead? Right? In that case, let's help gather those ores. Paimon's looking forward to this. Prisms within Alinus, number 2. Certain prisms can be picked up and redeployed at certain locations nearby. Adjust the position of the prism and let it resonate more. Move. It worked. Assuming I have to light this one up, unless I can put this one up. Something's broken. Oh, that was so close. Yeah. I see. It's a circle of target that you can hit. There we go. Ta-da! We did it. Mangler Paimon, sorry for the wait. Hey, that's... Hey, we weren't just watching, you know. We've also collected loads of pure ore. Awesome, right? Alright, thank you. Hey, nice, beautiful paints. Here we come. Let's head back, shall we? You seem rather crazed, Momiri. Hey, is it that obvious? Your tail's practically wagging. No, it isn't. Yeah, you're right, I am very happy. We can make lots of paints now. Well, yes, that is part of it. Oh, what about the other reasons then? Well, let's just head back first. Hey, Paimon's talking to you, you know. Let's go, Paimon. Whatever. Let's get back to the painting anyway. So let's just do that, Mangler. Elaine's little invention. It might as well have been yesterday since I last saw it. Huh? Boss? We searched her place. We couldn't find the paints you wanted. You couldn't? Yes, we did find some bottles that once contained paints, though. They gave off a very pungent smell that made us feel all queasy. I see, so the paints have been used up. Well, that's an unfortunate coincidence. Well then, Mr. Iris, please take your people and clean this place up. As things stand, this would make for too shocking a sight, I think. As for the paints, I'll figure out something later. Understood. Sorry, sir, we couldn't complete your commission. Before you could personally come to that little squirt's aid, those two strangers came and stole the moment. It's fine, I'll not be bothered by this. Well, it's not so much about that, but don't you think that this would count as a case of force majeure as such? About the remuneration we discussed previously. Don't worry, you'll be paid as per usual. But really? Thank you, sir. If only all our employers were as good-hearted as you. Whatever the case, I shan't take up any more of your time. Just clean these shambolic doodles up. Shambolic doodles? And what are you doing here? Hey, purple guy. Are you in cahoots with those thieves who wanted to steal Mamir's paintings? Oh, Paimon knows what you're up to, all right. You hired these people to steal her artwork and create an opportunity for you to rescue her, win her trust, and then achieve some unspeakable aims. Well, not that Paimon thinks getting paints counts as anything unspeakable, but eavesdropping is a bad habit, good sir, good lady. And you're the one to talk. Coming here on the sly and ransacking someone's house when they're not in. You've got some cheek to call others out. I believe we've met before, yes? Commendable memory you have, sir. Yes, we did have the honor of meeting near a cliff when you made a mess of my plans. It's just that, at that time, I don't think that you would have made the same choice as me to help Ms. Mamiri. Don't lump that in with your little one-man show. Me? You can call me Jacob. I'm a traveling collector of art. Good to see you again as well, Ms. Mamiri. Mr. Jacob. So, were all the things you told me lies? That you've never seen paintings like these before, and you'd like to collect them, and you could understand them. You did all that for things that have nothing to do with the paintings themselves, right? You misunderstand, Ms. Mulleary. I have never intended to deceive you. Even now, I know nothing. I have nothing but admiration for your work. But you called them shambolic doodles. And I apologize about my imprecise use of words. I was truly mesmerized by their unpredictable, chaotic nature, and I can appreciate the beauty in them. So incomprehensible to the rest of the world. Really? Of course I mean it. Your skills are most enchanting, and your use of colors and persistence in making your own paints truly make me... Hey, don't be taken in by him so easily. Huh? What, so this is a trick too? What do you want the paints for? What an interesting question. A fine question indeed, sir. Let me ask you about this instead. What else do you think these paints can be used for? Paimon doesn't know you what you want to do with them. But you can't be up to anything good. You tried to buy her paintings for a high price, and you also hired people to trouble her and ransack her house. You didn't have to go this far for your own drawings, did you? Yes, why indeed? Consider that a question for further exploration after this discussion. For now, let me venture a guess. You have just collected the raw materials for the paint, am I correct? In that case, sir, allow me to ask you a question. Would you give those materials to me? I have no quarrel with you. As such, we need not be enemies. In return, I can give you any amount of more, as long as it's within reason, of course. Why are you asking me? Exactly. These paints aren't ours. You should be asking Mamiri, shouldn't you? Are you really hoping for an answer, or are you simply probing about my attitude? Regardless, I will answer honestly. You and I both know that Ms. Mamiri cannot stop me from obtaining her paints. But if the same cannot be said for you... I never said anything like that. I'm not listening to you, you liar. Hush now. Say no more, Ms. Mamiri. You will give me the correct answer, won't you, sir? Of course we will. And that's a big fat no. Mamiri put in so much effort to create something so beautiful, and yet you're treating her like this. This is the answer the three of you have agreed on. Well then, understood. Allow me to thank you for helping me collect these paints. And well, though it disappoints me to say this, that will be all. That will be all. First you ransack someone's house, and then you say all that stuff, and now you want to run off? You misunderstand. I said, that will be all, not goodbye. Miss Iris, I'd like to change the original terms of our commission. Eh? Get rid of these people. As for your pay, will 7 times the original amount do? Huh? You don't think you can take Mangler out with just these few people, do you? You know, boss, she's right. We won't be able to take out that person by ourselves. We're mercenaries, you know. We should know more about combat than I do. Since you have the numbers, why are you fixated on your strongest foe? Is there not someone who cannot fight? Hey? You mean you want us to? What do you think you're doing? Walking sensible, necessary action toward achieving a future far beyond our imaginations. Sis, 7-fold pay, there's no argument, sir. Sorry, buddy. Hey. You mind my apprentice, m'lady? My primary directive is to garble with mechanical noises. Protect you. What? Seymour? Affirmative. I am here, m'lady, as you are as gentle, lovely, and radiant as ever. Please step back. Didn't expect to see a relic from those days ever again. Oops. Soft range, resistance is futile. Not climb on stuff, that's always tricky. Guess we just stomped him out. Did we drown him? Yes, we did. Did they all drown? Nope. as the last one. Well, what is this? Outdated junk, that's all. Elaine's own little adventure. You've been slumbering for years, haven't you? Still want to go at it? Yeah, just stop plotting all this bad stuff. Are you so obsessed with these paints anyway? Are they really worth you resorting to such despicable actions? Please, I've told you already why we are doing this. As for you, Ms. Mummery, if we should ever meet again, I look forward to your future drawings. You. Well, then I'll take my leave, good sir and ladies. Yes, and you, thinking machine. Let's go, Ms. Iris. We have other things to do. Hey, stop right there, purple guy. Please wait, you two. There's something wrong with Seymour. Garbled machine noises. My apologies, man. See, Seymour? He might be out of energy. Did he take damage during the battle? Oh, no, no. This can't be. Mamir, are you alright? Oh, Seymour, Mr. Jacob. He always intended to trick me by saying all these things like, I love your paintings and I understand your paintings. And even worse, he damaged you this badly. I won't forgive him. I won't. Mamiri, let's go look for an engineer in the court of Fontaine. They should be able to fix or even improve upon him. And we can also help you find more paints along the way. But let's pack things up a bit first. Oh, Paimon, hope your paintings weren't damaged during the fight. Thank you, Mangler, and you too, Paimon. It's just, what's the point of all my old work? If Seymour can't be cured, if Seymour can't appraise these works like he used to, artworks that no one understands, those aren't really artworks, are they? They're just what the person called them. Shambolic doodles. Don't say that. Even that purple guy said that there is something magical and inscrutably disordered about your work. Paimon loves your stuff too. Also, Paimon's wanted to say this before. What do you mean by everyone's in the village not understanding art? Exactly that. No one understands the paintings. Bah. They only don't get it because they don't have your artistic background, so they can't get the hidden meanings. Well, everything's about context anyway, right? That means you'll need societal knowledge and understanding of history. What Paimon means to say is, can we see the paintings? Sure. You pick up a painting from the ground. Paimon doesn't really understand the contents either, but looks really awesome, and this might sound unsuitable, but it looks like it might be super valuable right off the bat. It's so beautiful. For example, the details here. They've really got that immersive feeling. So don't you think so too? The other Melusines probably don't understand it because... You don't have to force yourself to say something nice, Paimon. I can see right through you. Still, I know you're doing this out of the goodness of your heart, so thank you. Sorry, Paimon couldn't tell what you painted, so... But it's really beautiful. Mangler, can you pack this stuff up? I can understand it. So that's how it was. I see. Yeah, so you mean the content of the painting? You don't need to comfort me with white lies. I'll pull myself together. Don't worry. This painting depicts two bears clapping their hands together, a drowned throne, a burning snowfield. I'll say the first one. Huh? Now that you mention it. Wait, you really got it? And, what do you think of this painting? It's very beautiful. It's worth savoring. It's very beautiful. Really? You don't have to lie, you know. Come on, Mamiri. Have some confidence. Paimon didn't get your painting, but she certainly thought it was very pretty. Yes, yes. Thank you. There are so many things I want to express from my paintings. So many beautiful things I want to see. It makes me so happy to hear you say that. Still, this really is the first time someone has understood my paintings. The other villagers think they're very beautiful, but that's all they tell me. Then, slowly, I begin to understand. Even though they don't get my paintings, they were still trying to be nice to me by saying they look beautiful. That's really kind of them, but I don't think that's good. So I was really happy when Jacob said that he understood what I was trying to convey through my paintings. I thought, finally, someone can see what I want to show. That purple guy, he's just awful. Right, but none of that matters now. Father told me to be of my beautiful sights. I feel that the world is a lovely place and it makes me happy. However, I'm not a very good speaker, so I want to make others happy through my pain. But most Melusines only know how to encourage me by saying that my paintings are beautiful. I like them too, but I still want to have someone around who gets my paintings. That's why Seymour is such an important friend to me. Unlike the others, he pays attention to my paintings and critiques them. That's also why I was very happy when I met Jacob. After I first heard that Jacob had said, I thought to myself, in the future I should only show my paintings to him. Others don't understand my work, so they only try to hurt my feelings. But since you and him can understand them, that means you're not entirely beyond comprehension. It means that there are people who can really see the beautiful things I wanted to show. So like Seymour, you're now my best friends too. Well, Paimon is happy about that, but it does feel weird compared to a robot dog. Regardless, let's continue cleaning up, shall we? Seriously, those bad guys really made a mess of this place, huh? You help her pick up the scattered paintings. Thank you. Sorry I made you clean up after me. You know, just like when we met for the first time. It's fine, we're friends after all. Yep. Looks like you're in a good mood again. That's great. Yep, I feel so happy when with you guys. Just like how I feel when I'm on a roll with my paintings. Still, looking at how you're packing these things up, I can't help but think about that you Melusines really have short hands. My hands are even shorter, Paimon. No way, short hands, Mamir. Yes, they are. Baby hands, Paimon. Alright. Paimon takes it back. But really, don't those hands make painting inconvenient? Your canvas does sit on a high stand. It's alright, since my hands aren't short at all, but speaking of painting, I really am sorry that I won't be able to paint for you at the moment. I just can't leave Seymour like this. I must fix him first. He is my best friend after all. But I'll paint for you once Seymour's all fixed up. Right, let's go to Court of Fontaine together and seek out a reliable engineer to help us. An engineer? No, that's not it. I want to fix him myself. Huh? Wait, you know how to fix Clockwork Mecha too? Strange that you would even ask, Paimon. Of course not. Huh? Mm-hmm. Hey? How are you going to fix him then? Paimon, Father said that he's seen a lot of machines, both intact and dismantled, so he can teach me how to fix Seymour. Father? You mentioned this Father a few times previously. What's he like? A master Melusin engineer with a long mustache? A Melusine with a wrench? Huh? Did Paimon say something bad? Why'd you keep stop talking? Yes, I see. Here we go again. Well, wait a moment. Who are you talking to? Are the ones I have at home not enough? Then, hey, Mamiri. Hello? Yes, I'll try. Thanks. So, Miss Mangler, Paimon? Whoa, wait, you're talking to us again? Father has told me how to cure Seymour. We just need to collect enough components, and come on, don't worry, I'll paint for you once Seymour's all fixed up. No, we're not worried about the painting. Ugh. Were you not talking? Who are you talking to just now? Father, of course. And who's that? Father's father? Wait, can the two of you not hear his voice? The voice, you say? Oh, yeah, of course we did. Does Seymour's breakdown hit her too hard or something? Anyway, let's just go along with this for now. We can cover her later. We heard it too. But we don't know anything about Clockwork Mecha, so what should we do exactly? Right, so we'll need to collect some components. Sure, but what kind? This is what I'm talking about. Pretty, isn't it? It's a screw. This is a scrap mechanical part. Are they really scrap though? They're shiny and pretty, and they're everywhere here. Everyone in the village really likes them, so they all have some. When we help each other out, we give the other components as tokens of gratitude. And Zana likes them too. Likes them more than most, so she often exchanges a lot of things for them. Oh, but she doesn't seem to be in the village. So they're currently specific to Marusi Village? Currency. Oh, I get it, like Mora. Well, I guess you can say that. Even if Jacob were to give me a lot of components in exchange for my paintings, I wouldn't accept. Unless it would help me fix Seymour. Alright, sure. Well, we just need to collect components, right? We'll help. No way, they're like Mora, you know. Getting parts for me would be like me asking you to, earn Mora for me. That sounds like something a villain would do. I'm fine, I'm used to it. Okay. Thank you, you're nice people. I'll also go hunt them down myself. I really can't ask you to help find them for me while I just sit around doing nothing. Part 2, A Gradient of Dreams and Open. Alright, this is another go-fetching quest type thing. I'm gonna go ahead and put a cut in the video for now. I'm gonna go see if anyone else is on. I think I saw a couple people when I started. They're probably still on. They are. Let's go ahead and let's raid Tyler Salt. We haven't raided him in a while, so let's go with that. Here we go. Have a wonderful weekend. See you next time.